Good afternoon all, welcome to the lecture of discrete mathematical structure. In last lecture we have completed what is an awk, open awk, closed awk, trail, circuit, path, cycle, and after that we have seen what are the directed graphs. Now we have to see how to find out the degrees in a directed graph, that is degrees of a vertex in a directed graph. Okay. Screen is visible. स्क्रीन शेयर झाली का तुमच्याशी?
यस सर.
ओके, नाउ देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ डिग्रीज इन अ डायरेक्टेड ग्राफ, दैट इज आउट डिग्री ऑफ अ वर्टेक्स एंड इन डिग्री ऑफ अ वर्टेक्स. फर्स्ट वी विल सी व्हाट इज एन आउट डिग्री ऑफ वर्टेक्स. ओके, and this can be formed in only directed graphs. In general graph we can easily find out its degree of any vertex, but as here the edges are directed in graph, then we have to find out its degree in two ways. Okay, let us see first what is an outer degree of a vertex. For that we require g must be a directed graph. Let g be a directed graph. Directed graph. Directed graph is also called as digraph. Okay, the outer degree of a vertex v of g, that is vertex v of graph g, is denoted by outer degree of vertex v, and it is nothing but is the number of edges beginning at vertex v. That is, outer degree of any vertex v of a graph g is nothing but the number of edges which are beginning at vertex v. That is, for example, let us see. Suppose this one be a graph v1, v2, v3 and v4, as this one is a directed graph, this will be a graph g, and graph g is a directed graph, then its edges must be directed. Okay, this one will be edge e1, e2, e3, e4 and e5. Now here we have to find out the out degree of vertex v1. Suppose we have to find out the out degree of vertex v1, then according to definition of outer degree, outer degree is nothing but the number of edges beginning at v. Suppose we have to find out the out degree of vertex v1, that is outer degree of vertex v1, which is nothing but here we have to see how many edges are beginning at vertex v1. There is only one edge e2 which is beginning at vertex v1, that is, it is from v1 to v2, that is, it begins at vertex v1. Therefore, outer degree of vertex v1 will be 1, since there is only one edge e2 which is beginning at vertex v1. Therefore, outer degree of vertex v1 is nothing but 1. Similarly, outer degree of vertex v2 is nothing but, here again, there is only one edge e3 which is beginning at vertex v2. Therefore, its outer degree is again 1. Now, outer degree of v3. Out degree of v3. Now again there is an edge e5 which is begins at vertex v3, then its out degree is again 1, and out degree of vertex v4. Here there is an edge e1 which is begins at vertex v4, similarly edge e4 which is also begins at vertex v4, then its out degree must be equal to 2. Okay, now we have to see what is an in degree of a vertex. Okay. And for that we have to take, let G be a directed graph then the in degree of vertex V in graph G is denoted by in degree of vertex V, and it is the number of edges ending at vertex V. Beginning at vertex V is nothing but out degree, and ending at vertex V is nothing but the in degree. Okay, see its example. Okay. This will be a graph G with vertices R A B C and D, and edges are E1, E2, E3 and E4. That is G be a graph with 4 vertices and 4 edges, and as edges are directed in graph, then it must be a directed graph. Now we have to find out the in degree of each vertex in this graph. Therefore, in degree of vertex A is nothing but, now we have to see how many edges are ending at vertex V. There is only one edge which is incident on vertex A and which is begins at vertex A. Therefore, there is no edge ending at vertex A, then its in degree must be equal to 0. Now, in degree of vertex B, which is equal to, there is one edge E1 which is ending at vertex B, then its in degree will be 1. Similarly, in degree of vertex C, there are 2 edges incident on vertex C, in which one E4 begins at vertex C and E3 is ending at vertex C, then its in degree will be 1. And in degree of vertex D is equal to, here edge E2 is ending at vertex D, E3 is begins at vertex D, and E4 is ending at D, then its in degree will be 2, since E2 and E4 are 2 edges which are ends at vertex D. Okay. Now, there is one theorem depending on these concepts, that is, it's a general statement. Note, the sum of out degrees of the vertices in a diagraph G, that is directed graph G, equal to the sum of in degrees of the vertices of G and which equals to the number of edges in G. Okay. So this will be a note which says that the sum of the outer degrees of the vertices in a diagram G is equal to the sum of the in degrees of the vertices of G, and which is nothing but the total number of edges in a graph G. We will see by example. Let us take one example. Okay, so here is one eighth vertex. V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6, V7 and V8. As this one is the directed graph, then its edges must have a direction. Now we have to prove this statement here. That is, first we have to find out the outer degrees of each of the vertices of graph G. Similarly, we have to find out the in degrees of the vertices. And after that, we have to show that the sum of outer degrees of the vertices in this graph G is equal to the sum of the in degrees of the vertices in this similar graph G. And after that, we have to prove that it equals to the number of edges, the edges in G. Now let us first find out its number of edges. That is E1, E2. E3, 8, E9, E10, I think there is one. E1, E2, E3, E4, E5, E6, E7. As already we have given an H E4, therefore here is E7, E8, this one will be E9, and this one is nothing but E10. That is, here number of edges will be equal to 10. Now we have to first find out the outer degrees of each of these vertices of a graph G. Okay, now outer degree of vertex V1, that is the number of edges which begins at vertex V1. Okay, there are only two edges, which are E1 and E2, which are incident on vertex V1, where E1 is ending at V1 and E2 is begins at vertex V1. Then its outer degree will be 1. Similarly, outer degree of vertex V2, which is equal to, now there are three edges, E2, E10 and E3, in which E2 and E3 are ending at V2 and E10 begins at vertex. Therefore, its outer degree will be, similarly at a time we will find out its in degree also. That is in degree of V1. Okay, that is in degree of V1, in degree of V2, in degree of V7 and in degree of V8. Okay. And similarly, we have to find out its outer degrees. Outer degree of V3, outer degree of V4, 5 and out degree of phi 8. Okay, now here out degree of phi 1 will be 1 and in degree of phi 1 is also 1. Now out degree of E2 will be B2, that is the number of edges ending at vertex B2 will be E2 and E3, therefore its in degree will be 2. Now out degree of vertex V3, the number of edges which are begins at vertex V3. Okay, here vertex edge E3 will be begins at vertex V3 and E4 is also begins at V3, and edge E8 is ending at vertex V3, therefore its in degree will be 1 and out degree will be 2. Okay, now ending E5 is also ending and E7 is also ending, therefore its in degree will be 3 and out degree will be 0, since there is no edge begins at vertex V4. Okay, now out degree of vertex V5, both the edges are begins at vertex V5, then its in degree out degree will be 2 and in degree will be 0. V6, there is an edge E6 which is ending at V6 and E7 begins at V6, therefore out degree and in degree both are 1 1. Okay, now for vertex V7, there are again 3 edges which are incident on vertex V7, in which E9 will be ending at V7. Similarly, E10 is also ending at V7. Then its in degree will be 2 and edge E8 is begins at vertex V7. Then its out degree will be 1. Now for V8, there are only 2 edges and both are begins at vertex V8. Then its out degree will be 2 and in degree will be 0. Okay, now first we have to take the sum of out degrees of the vertices in graph D. Therefore the sum of the out degrees of the vertices of graph G is equal to out degree is nothing but 1 plus 1 plus 2 plus 0 1 plus 1 plus 2 plus 0 2 plus 1 plus 2 plus 1 plus 1 plus 2, and which is nothing but 1 plus 1 2 2 plus 2, sum of the in degree of the vertices of G equals to 1 plus 2 plus 1 plus 3 plus 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 0, and which is equal to 1 plus 2 3 3 plus 1 4 4 plus 3 7 7 plus 1 8 8 plus 2 10. Okay, so here the sum of the out degrees of the vertices of G will be 10 and the sum of the in degrees of the vertices of G is again 10, and the number of edges in given graph G will be 10, that is e1 e2 e3 e4, add up to so on e10. Therefore this statement will be true, that is the sum of the out degrees of the vertices in directed graph G equals to the sum of the vertices in that graph G equals to the sum of the in degrees of the vertices of graph G, and which is nothing but the total number of edges in given graph G. Kunal kahi doubt ya madhe? Okay, if there is no doubt, then there is one known. The vertex with 0 in degree is called source, and a vertex with zero out degree is called sink. Okay, so a vertex having in degree will be zero is called a source, and a vertex having out degree will be equal to zero is called sink. Therefore, now this will be an vertex with zero in degree, and similarly vertex V8 is an vertex with zero in degree. Then they are called source and a vertex with zero out degree, that is vertex V4. This will be an vertex V4 having out degree will be zero, and it is called sink. Okay, now the next concept will be distance and diameter of a graph G. Distance and diameter. Okay, now first we will see what is an distance. Let G be a connected graph, be a connected graph the distance between any two vertices U and V of graph G is denoted by D of UV and is the length of shortest path between vertices U and V. So if given graph G will be a connected graph, then the distance between any two vertices of that graph G is denoted by D of UV, and distance between these two vertices UV is nothing but the length of a shortest path between these two vertices U and V. Let us take one example. Suppose this one is a graph G. Takes A, B, C, D. E. Now we have to find out the distance between vertices A and vertex G. Okay. Now here is vertex A and here is vertex G. Distance between any two vertices is nothing but the length of a shortest path between U and V. Now here there is a path from A to G is nothing but A to B, B to D, and D to G, and in which there are three edges, that is A to B first one, B to D second one, and D to G third one. Therefore its length will be three, but here we have to take the length of shortest path, that is here the shortest path is nothing but A to D and D to G, and which includes, what is that? This one. Therefore, length of a shortest path between these two vertices A and G is nothing but 2. Okay. Now, similarly, distance between A and V. We can go through this path also, that is A to B, B to D, and D to E. But here we have to take the shortest path. Therefore, we have to go A to D and D to E. Again, its length will be 2. Similarly, distance between B and F, that is F and B, or B and F, B to D and D to F, its length is again 2. So here if we take any two vertices of graph G, then its distance must be equal to 2 only. Okay, either 2 or less than 2. For example, distance between D and G will be we can go through this path also, that is D to E and E to G, but its length will be 2. And if we go direct D to G, then its length will be 1. Therefore, as here we have to find out the shortest path, then we have to go through D to G, that is its length will be 1. In this way, we can easily find out the distance between any two vertices of a given graph G. Okay. This will be an first example. Let us see second one. This will be an vertex A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. Now, find out the distance between vertices A and F. Distance between A and F is A to B, B to D, D to E, and E to F. We have to go in this path, or A to C, C to D, D to E, and E to F. And there are four edges in between this path. Therefore, distance between A and F will be 4. Distance between A and G is again 4. Distance between B and G, which is equal to B to D, D to E, and E to G, which is equal to 3. Distance between D to A is 2. Distance between D to F is equal to 2. Distance between E to G is 1. That is the shortest path is this one, E to G. And distance between C to F is nothing but C to D. So we can find out the distance between any two vertices of a graph G. Now we have to see, this will be an distance. Now we have to see what is an diameter of a graph G. Okay. Diameter of graph G. Let G be a connected graph. Then its diameter is denoted by diameter of graph G, and it is nothing but maximum distance any two vertices of graph G. If suppose this one is a graph G1 and this one is a graph G2, and we have to find out its diameter. Diameter is nothing but the distance between maximum distance between any two vertices of a graph G. In this example, the maximum distance between any two vertices of a graph G will be 2, and the minimum will be 0. That is the distance of D from itself, that is 0. And if you take distance from D to G, which is nothing but 1, and if you take any two vertices, then its maximum distance will be 2. Therefore, diameter of a graph G1 will be 2. From graph G1, as the maximum distance between any two vertices of a graph G will be 2, then its diameter is equal to 2. But in graph G2, here the maximum distance between any two vertices of a graph G2 will be 4. That is distance from A to F or F to A. Similarly, distance from A to G or G to A. That is the maximum distance between the vertices of a graph G2, and which is equal to diameter of a graph G2 is equal to 4. Okay? Now, Kunal, any doubt? Now, next concept is nothing but eccentricity of a vertex. Okay. Let us see its definition. Let G be a connected graph. With vertex set V, capital V. Thus, for each V belonging to V, V belonging to vertex set V, the eccentricity of vertex small v is denoted by E of V and is defined as eccentricity of vertex V is equal to maximum of distance between vertices U and V whenever U is belonging to vertex V and U is not equal to V. So how will you find out the eccentricity of any vertex? First, we have to find out the distance between vertex V to all the remaining vertices of a graph G, and we have to take the maximum among these distances, and which is nothing but the eccentricity of a vertex V. For example, suppose this one is a graph. Vertex A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. Now, if suppose we have to find out the eccentricity of a vertex A, that is eccentricity of vertex A, and by definition, which is nothing but maximum of distance between all the vertices U, which is not equal to A, and vertex A whenever these U belonging to vertex set of this graph G and U is not equal to vertex A. Okay, so which is nothing but, now first we have to find out the distance from A to all the remaining vertices. Now, distance between vertex A, A to B, which is nothing but 1. Since here we have to take the shortest path, therefore distance from, that is, this one can be written as, which is actually nothing but maximum of distance from B to A, distance from C to A, distance from D to A, distance from E to A, distance from F to A, and distance from G to A. Okay, so which is nothing but maximum of distance from B to A, that is the shortest path from B to A, which is 1. Distance from C to A is again 1. Distance from D to A, which is E to D, D to C, C to A, or E to D, D to B, and B to A. Its distance will be 3. Distance from E to A is 3. Distance from F to A is 4, and distance from G to A is also 4. Okay. Now we have to take the maximum among these, and which is nothing but 4. Therefore, eccentricity of vertex A is equal to 4. Similarly, we have to find out the eccentricity of remaining vertices. Okay. Now from this graph, eccentricity of vertex B, which is nothing but maximum of now distance from all the remaining vertices, that is B to A is 1, B to D 1, B to C 2, B to E 2, B to F 3, and B to G is again 3, and its maximum will be 3. Therefore, eccentricity of B is 3. Eccentricity of C, which is equal to C to maximum of C to A, C to A 1, C to B 2, C to D 1, C to E 2, C to F 3, and C to G is again 3. Therefore, its eccentricity is again 3. Now for eccentricity of vertex D, which is maximum distance from D to A, which is 2, distance from D to B 1, distance from D to C 1, distance from D to E 1, distance from D to F is 2, and distance from D to G is again 2. Therefore, its eccentricity will be 2, since maximum will be 2. Eccentricity of E, which is equal to maximum of E to A 3, E to B 2, E to C 2, E to D 1, E to F 1, E to G 1, and maximum will be 3. Now E to eccentricity of vertex F, which is nothing but maximum of now F to A 4, F to B 3, F to C 3, F to D 2, F to E 1, F to G 1, and which is 4. Similarly, eccentricity of vertex G, and which is same as it is a F, which is 4, 3, 3, 2, 1, and 1, and which is equal to 4. Therefore, the eccentricity of vertex A is nothing but 4. Eccentricity of B will be 3. Eccentricity of C is 3. Eccentricity of D will be 2. Eccentricity of E is nothing but 3. And eccentricity of F and G will be equal to 4. So, in this way, we can find out the eccentricities of given graph G. Now, from that, we have to define one new concept, which is a radius of a graph G. Radius of graph G. Okay. Radius of G is denoted by radius of G and is defined as radius of graph G is equal to minimum of eccentricity of V whenever each V is belonging to vertex set V. Each V, small V, belonging to vertex set V. So radius of graph G is nothing but, first we have to find out the eccentricities of all the vertices of a graph G, and minimum among them is nothing but the radius of that graph G. Therefore, from above graph, from this graph will be a graph, this will be nothing but G3. Okay. This is nothing but G3. Okay. Now graph, from graph G3, radius of graph G3 is nothing but minimum of eccentricities of all its vertices, that is eccentricity of A comma eccentricity of B comma eccentricity of E, C, D, E, F, and eccentricity of G, and which is equal to minimum of Now, eccentricity of A will be 4, eccentricity of B is 3, C is again 3, so 4, 3, 3, and eccentricity of D will be 2, eccentricity of E is nothing but 3, and eccentricity of F and G are 4, okay? 2, 3, 4, 4. Now we have to take the minimum among these numbers, which is nothing but 2. Therefore, radius of graph G, which is denoted by radius of G3, is equal to 2. Okay? Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. Now, the next concept is nothing but the central graph. Okay. The center of a graph is set of having minimum eccentricity. So, if we have to find out the center of a graph, then we have to find out the eccentricity of all the vertices of a graph G and the collection of all the vertices having minimum eccentricity is nothing but the center of that graph. Let us see its example. Suppose this is a graph. Suppose this one has an vertex A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and this one is an I. Okay, so these are the vertices of a given graph G. Okay, now we have to first find out the eccentricities of all the vertices of this graph G. Okay, that is, first find out the eccentricity of vertex A. Okay. Eccentricity of vertex A is nothing but the maximum of distance between any vertex to its A. And we have to take the maximum among these distances, and which is nothing but the eccentricity of A. Now, the maximum distance between any two vertices in this graph will be A to F, that is A to B, B to I, I to C, C to E, and E to F, and its distance is nothing but 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. The eccentricity of this graph, eccentricity of vertex A will be 5. Since first we have to find out the distance from A to all the vertices of a graph G, and we have to take the maximum among these, but the distance from A to F is maximum between B to I, I to C, C to E, and E to F. That one is the maximum distance, and which is nothing but 4. Now, eccentricity of I, which is equal to, now, I to B, B to A, its distance will be 2. I to C, C to D, it's again 2. I to C, C to E, and E to F will be 3, and it is the maximum distance. Since there is no vertex from I to any other vertex, that is that vertex, which have maximum distance than 3. Therefore, eccentricity of I will be 3 only. Eccentricity of C is equal to C to E, E to F, its distance will be 2. C to E, E to G, G to H, it will be 3. And C to B, C to I to B, B to A, which is again 3. Then its eccentricity will be 3. Eccentricity of D, which is equal to D to C, C to I, I to B, B to A, it will be 4. d2 c c2 e e2 g g2 h, it's again 4, therefore this one will be the maximum. Okay, now eccentricity of E, which is nothing but E to G, G to I, I to B, B to A, or E to C, C to I, I to B and B to E, which is 4 only. Eccentricity of F, eccentricity of F will be 5, since F to A is the maximum distance. Eccentricity of G, which is nothing but G to E, E to C, C to D, 3. G to I to B, B to A, which is again 3, then this will be the maximum. Eccentricity of H is nothing but H to G, G to E, E to C, C to D, H to G, G to I to B and B to E, which is 4. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So here we can find out the eccentricity of all the vertices. Now we have to find out the center of a graph. Now, and for that we have to find out the all those vertices having minimum eccentricity. So here eccentricities have the vertices having minimum eccentricity will be I, C and G, since its eccentricity will be 3. So center of graph G is nothing but center of graph G, that is, which is denoted by C of G, contains all those vertices having minimum eccentricity. Okay, and I, C and G are the vertices having minimum eccentricity. Therefore, this one is nothing but the center of graph G. Okay, any doubt? Just here we have to find out the eccentricities of all the vertices, and we have to take all those vertices having minimum eccentricity, and that collection of that vertices is nothing but the center of your given graph. Okay, now the next concept will be a planar graph. Let G be a graph with vertex set V and edge set E. V and edge set E. Okay. The graph G is called planar if it can be drawn in a plane and no two of its edges will cross, and no two of its edges will cross. Okay, so any graph G with vertex set V and edge set E is said to be a planar graph if it can be drawn in a plane in such a way that no two of its edges will cross to each other. That is, for example, so this one is a graph G1. Okay, so here these are the edges E1, E2, E3, E4 and E5, and no two of its edges will cross, and this graph will be drawn in a plane. Therefore, this graph is a planar graph, since here no two of its edges will cross. This one is first one. Now second one is nothing but this one is again a planar graph. Okay, since here also there is no edge crossing between the edges, so So this one is again a planar graph. A graph which cannot be drawn in a plane without a crossover between its edges, crossover between its edges is called a non-planar graph. Okay. If there is an edge cross between the edges of a graph, then the graph is called as a non-planar graph. Let us see its example. So this will be a graph G with vertex set V and edge set E. As here there is an edge crosses in between the vertices of a graph G. Therefore, this will graph is a non-planar graph. Since it holds the definition of non-planar graph, since there is an crossover between the vertices, that is the edges of this graph G. And according to this definition, this will be a non-planar graph. And the next graph will be an Eulerian graph. Eulerian graph. Its definition is nothing but a graph G is said to be Eulerian if it is connected and every vertex of G is of even degree. Okay, so any graph G is called a Eulerian graph. Then it has two conditions, that is the graph G must be a connected graph, and second condition is nothing but its every vertex will be of even degree. Then only the corresponding graph G will be said to be a Eulerian graph. See its example. Okay, now we have to see whether G1, G2 and G3 are Eulerian graphs. And for that we have to check two conditions. That is, the graph will be connected and every vertex of G is of even degree. Now here G1, G2, G3, all of these three graphs are connected since there is an edge joining between the each of these vertices, that is, they are connected by a path. Therefore, e1, e2, e3, all are connected. So here, just we have to check whether every vertex of these graphs are of e1 degree or not. Now, here degree of v1 will be 2, which is e1. Degree of v2 will be 2, and degree of v4 and v5 is again 2. Therefore, v1, v2, v4, and v5 are of e1 degree, and degree of v3 will be 4. That is, there are 4 edges incident on vertex v3, which is again e1. Therefore, each vertex of g1 is of e1 degree. Then, from the definition of Eulerian graph, graph g1 is a Eulerian. Okay. Now, here vertex A is of degree 2, B is of degree 4, C, E, and F are again of degree 4, and D is a vertex of degree 2. Therefore, all these 6 vertices are of e1 degree. Therefore, g2 is again a Eulerian graph. Now, for g3, here vertex A is of degree 2, vertex B and C are the vertices of degree 3. Therefore, here there are 2 vertices having degree 3, and which is an odd number, that is, it is not a even number, which implies here it does not satisfy the definition of Eulerian graph. This, therefore, this graph is not a Eulerian graph. And the last type of graph is nothing but the Hamiltonian graph. Hamiltonian graph. A graph G is said to be Hamiltonian if it contains a cycle which includes all the vertices of graph G. Then the graph G is said to be a Hamiltonian graph. That is, here we have to show that the existence of such a cycle which includes all the vertices of a graph G. Okay, see its example. This will be a graph G1. And this will be graph G2. Now we have to check whether graph G1 and G2 are Hamiltonian graph or not. Okay. Now, any graph B is said to be a Hamiltonian graph if it contains a cycle which includes all the vertices of G. And cycle is nothing but, in last lecture we have seen, what is a cycle? A path is said to be a cycle if its only repeated vertices are the end vertices. That is, there is a vertices which are repeated are only the end vertices. Then only the corresponding graph will be cycle. If there is a repetition of vertices in between the walk, then the corresponding walk is not a cycle. Okay, so here for graph G1, there is one path, that is vertex V1 to E1, E1 to V2, V2 to E2 to V3, to E3 to V4 to E4 to V1. Okay, so this one will be a walk. First, it will be a walk. And any walk is said to be a path if its all of its edges and vertices are different. And any path is said to be a cycle if its only end vertices are same and there is no repetition of vertices in between its end vertices. As here, V1, V2, V3 and V4 all are different vertices, and E1, E2, E3 and E4 are different edges. Therefore, here there is only one vertex which is repeated, that is vertex V1, and which is a end vertex and which is alluded in its definition of cycle. Therefore, this will be a cycle which includes all the vertices of a graph G, that is V1, V2, V3 and V4 are only the four vertices of a graph G1 and they are present in this cycle. Therefore, there exists one cycle in which all the vertices of graph G1 will be present. Therefore, graph G1 will be a Hamiltonian graph. If we have find out once V2 to E2, E2 to V3, V3 to E3, E3 to V4 and V4 to E4 and E4 to V2 and V2 to E1, E1 to V1. Here the end vertices are different, but there is a repetition of vertex V2 in this walk. Therefore, this one is a not a path, since for path we require all of its edges and vertices are different, and for cycle there is a path in which the only end vertices are similar. Here end vertices are similar, but in between these end vertices vertex V2 is same. Therefore, this one is not a path. If this is not a path, then it must be not a cycle, which implies it is not a cycle. Therefore, here there does not exist any cycle which includes all the vertices of a graph G. Therefore, this graph is not a Hamiltonian graph. Okay. कोणाल काही डाउट असतील तर विचार.